Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Jennifer Costantinidis of Dun Roman Danes. Great Danes are my passion. These Danes are born into my hands. For me, the beginning of a Great Dane like this one starts from before she's born, with the creation of her, putting together two pedigrees I believe are going to blend well to give me type, soundness, and a complete animal that will be sound of mind and body, and then breeding, whelping, and raising the litter. And that's just the beginning. I brought three with me. The first female is laying at my feet. This is Grand Champion Dun Romans Just Like You, Only Prettier, CGC TKN. And Miranda is not only a show dog, she is my companion, my best hiking buddy, and one of my best friends. She is the mother of a 10-month-old litter that I am now currently showing one of those puppies in Bred by Exhibitor. The second female is Champion Birdie, who is Champion Dun Romans Keeping It Fly, CGC TKN. And she is the mother of the 4-month-old puppy that I brought with me today. The 4-month-old puppy is by our number 5 Great Dane from last year, BISS Grand Champion Silver Champion Dun Romans Jackpot, I Love You 3000 AOM, and that's Tony, and he is the sire of Harley, and Birdie is the dam. A lot of people think that Great Danes are goofy and fun like Scooby or Marmaduke, and I would like the general population of the world to know that a Great Dane shows in the working group because it is a working dog. It was bred to do a function and it was bred to work. It should be intelligent, trainable, and it should not behave like goofy or not intelligent. Some of the males can be a little goofy as they're growing up, but a Great Dane should be an intelligent, trainable animal. They bring me joy, laughter, security. I will take 3 Great Danes and hike anywhere. I don't worry about what I'm going to encounter on a trail when I'm hiking with 3 working dogs. Their energy and my energy is very well matched because I have bursts of energy, but I'm not a constant source of energy. So we could go out, we can hike 3 to 5 miles, and then we could come back and relax. And I just find that the breed is well suited for me and how I'm wired. Nutritionally, we feed a high quality kibble, but I do add supplements, and I also add blueberries, fresh proteins, beef, chicken, on occasion. But you need to feed a high quality kibble, and you need to do a lot of research on dog food because some dog foods are marketed very well, but they're nutritionally lacking. The biggest health concern I would say for the breed would be bloat. And how that can be addressed is you can electively gastropexy your Great Dane when it becomes an adult and take that off the table. After a Great Dane is gastropexied, they can bloat, but they will not torsion, and it's torsion that is deadly. That would be one of the biggest concerns in the breed, provided you purchase from a breeder who does echocardiograms and has x-rayed the hips, elbows, and done the thyroid. If you've done your research on your breeder, one of the things that no breeder of a deep-chested dog, giant breed or otherwise, could take completely off the table is bloat and torsion. If you are looking for a Great Dane puppy, The first thing to do is reach out to lots of breeders and see who you have a rapport with. The second thing to do would be to meet their dogs and see who's appealing to you. Also, to see how their dogs behave. You do not want to purchase a puppy from someone who has dogs that behave in a way that wouldn't be suitable to your lifestyle. After all of that, you want to make sure that the dogs have been properly health tested. So if you go to the Great Dane Club of America website, it will give you a list of reputable breeders across the U.S., and then you can go on to the Orthopedic Foundation of America and check all their health testing. I would also ask about the puppy's sire and dam's grandparents and also vertical pedigree, because history is the best guess at the future. I have rescued a couple Great Danes because I feel preservationist breeders also have to give back to the breed. Rescue is a very tricky question because, as a breeder, and this could be an unpopular opinion, I don't believe all dogs should be rescued. I believe that if a dog has bit people or is a threat to human beings, that dog should not be rescued, that the kindest thing to do would be to euthanize it. And that's not a popular opinion, but you're not dealing with a chihuahua. You're dealing with an animal over 100 pounds that could be a lethal weapon and is capable of taking someone's life. So I think you should approach rescue very carefully, and you should build a rapport with someone running a rescue that you feel is forthright and is dog savvy enough to properly evaluate and place a Great Dane, because not all rescues are the same. And I don't like to see this breed involved in anything unsavory. If you want to learn more about the breed, you can visit the Great Dane Club of America website. You could also look for your local breed club. So I'm a part of the Great Dane Club of San Diego. There are clubs all across the United States with dedicated people that are trying to further the education and best interest of the breed. You could reach out to them. I would also say that you could contact a breeder and ask them if they have anyone living in your area with one of their dogs that you could go meet or reach out to and ask them what their experience has been as a Great Dane owner. The breed is not for everyone. With a dog this size comes great responsibility. So if you don't want to spend time training, or you're very busy and you don't have time to socialize, this is not a breed that you would be well suited for. You need owners that are dedicated to bringing them upright. Thank you for watching today. You can locate us on Instagram at Dunn Roman Danes, or you can find me on social media on Facebook, Jennifer Costantinidis.